बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स। दिस इज आवर नेक्स्ट मॉड्यूल, मॉड्यूल नंबर MECH_P_071_Douglas C. ज्ञान कोली। स्टेटमेंट, एन इनअटेंटिव ड्राइवर इज ट्रेवलिंग 18.0 मीटर पर सेकेंड when he notices a red light ahead. His car is capable of decelerating at a rate of 3.65 meter per second square. Deceleration means negative acceleration, okay? If it takes him 0.200 second to get the brakes on and he is 20.0 meter from the intersection when he sees the light, will he be able to stop in time? Okay dear students, apparently it seems a little harder problem, but in fact it is quite simple. Okay, an inattentive driver is traveling 18.0 meter per second when he notices a red light ahead. His car is capable of decelerating at a rate of 3.65 meter per second square. If it takes him 0.200 second to get the brakes on and he is 20 meter from the intersection when he sees the light, will he be able to stop in time? Let us see whether he will be able or not able to stop within time. Okay, solution. Dear students, in this statement some data is given and some data is to be determined. So first we arrange the given and required data. Okay, let us arrange the given and required data as under. Number one, initial velocity which is denoted by V naught is equal to 18.0 meter per second. This is given. Okay, initial velocity is equal to V naught equal to 18.0 meter per second. Final velocity denoted by simply V is equal to 0 as it comes to rest. Delta t is equal to 0.200 second. Acceleration a is equal to minus 3.65 meter per second square because it is deceleration, okay, retardation. Okay, let delta x1 be the distance traveled by car during the reaction time. Let delta x2 be the distance traveled by car during the deceleration. Okay, above data is given, while the last mentioned delta x1, delta x2 are to be determined. After determining delta x1 and delta x2, we will add these two distances, and if their addition is less than the distance mentioned in the statement, then we will conclude that driver will be able to stop the car seeing red light. And if addition of these two distances exceeds the distance traveled in the statement, then we will conclude that he will fail. Okay. Now, V naught is equal to delta x1 over delta t. This This implies that 18.0 meter per second is equal to delta x1 over 0.200 second. What we have done? We have simply put the values, accept the value of delta x1 which is to be determined, okay? This implies that delta x1 is equal to 18.0 meter per second into 0.200 second. Second will be cancelled with second, and so delta x1 will become equal to 3.6 meter. This is our first required result, okay? We have found delta x1. Similarly, we will found delta x2 and then add these two distances. And if this addition exceeds the specified distance, we will conclude that driver will be unable within the specified time. Okay, if it becomes less than that mentioned distance, then we will conclude that driver will succeed in stopping the car before traffic signal. Okay. Now we come towards determining delta x2. For determining delta x2, we use different equation of motion. Okay. Now we use the equation v square is equal to v naught square plus 2a delta x2. This implies that 0 is equal to 18.0 meter per second whole square plus 2 into minus 3.65 meter per second square into delta x2. What we have done? We have simply put the values. V is because 0, so in place of V we have used 0. In place of V naught we have used 18.0 meter per second. In place of acceleration A we have used minus 3.65 meter per second square because it is deceleration, retardation, okay? While delta x2 is to be determined, this implies that delta x2 is equal to 18.0 meter per second whole square into 1 over 2 into 3.65 second square per meter. Because, dear students, when we will keep delta x2 on one side, then 2 into 3.65, which is being multiplied with delta x2, will be divided on other side of equality. Okay. This implies that delta x2 is equal to 324 meter square per second square into 1 over 7.3 second square per meter. Okay, second square will be cancelled with second square while 1 meter will be cancelled from square of meter and simply meter will be left. Okay, so delta x2 will alternatively become equal to 44.38 meter. Okay, we have found delta x1 equal to 3.6 meter and delta x2 equal to 44.38 meter. Now we will add these two distances. Okay. Now delta x is equal to delta x1 plus delta x2 is equal to 3.6 meter plus 44.38 meter, which alternatively becomes equal to 47.98 meter. As 47.98 meter is greater than 20.0 meter, which is given in the statement as a criteria for being able or being unable to stop the car at required time and place. Okay. As 47.98 meter is greater than 20.0 meter, so driver will not be able to stop the car in time. And this is the end of our module. Okay.